Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. A very common misconception which is found regarding the economic directives of Islam is that it is generally thought that Islam has an economic system. The Quran has given Muslims a very specific economic systems, and all that is required is that in areas and territories where Muslims are independent and they can enforce their own laws, they just need to implement this economic system. Now, this is an absolutely misnomer. We find no economic system mentioned in the Quran. All that the Quran gives is that there are primary directives, there are primary laws, institutes regarding the economic sphere. We do not find any economic system written in the Quran. All that the Quran gives is that there are certain directives, there are certain laws and rules which have to be followed and which are eternal. And the beauty of this is that the system which has to be made on the basis of these laws shall accommodate the circumstances of various societies. For example, today in Pakistan, this system will be entirely different from the one which can be made in Indonesia, in Sudan, in other Muslim countries. Similarly, it can be different in different periods of time, accommodating the culture, society, and the nature of circumstances of those areas and times. So therefore, it is absolutely essential to realize the fact that Islam or the Quran does not give any economic system. It has no intentions of giving an economic system. And the primary reason for this is that the Almighty thinks that Muslims and human beings in general have been equipped, intellectually equipped and innately equipped with certain abilities, and they can decide a lot of things on their own selves in economic affairs. It is only on certain crossroads, certain areas in which their own intellect is unable to decide the right course of path, the right path in which these directives are given. So therefore, we have to realize that Islam does not give any economic system. All that it gives is an economic law, an economic statute on the basis of which the system has to be developed, it has to be made, and as I said, it can be different in different periods of time. And this beauty has been kept in it so that the difference in circumstances of various spheres, various areas, various territories, various countries is also accommodated. And we must not think that Islam has given an economic system, and if we think so, we will be disappointed. And we come to realize that after so many centuries of work on Islamic economics, not a single country has succeeded to produce any economic system simply because they are looking for the wrong thing at the wrong place. The Quran, as I said, does not give any economic system. It gives certain economic rules, certain economic statutes. The task of making a system has been left to economists, to Islamic economists, for example. They should come forward and in the light of these statutes, in the light of these rules and these laws, they should make a system which should be specific to the circumstances in the area which they live. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ